great deal, big smile on your face. Yeah. Talk us through the rationale and the timing.
Well, firstly, excuse my voice. I think I've been talking so much for the last few days, I nearly lost it last night, which would have been a challenge with investors today. You know, the rationale is this is sort of the next step in our journey. I mean, it's got implications for the wealth management business first and foremost. There's been a convergence of technology across all platforms. And this gives us, you know, access to both the workplace, the direct, as well as our core financial advisory, which is unchanged. It's just added to. And then for Morgan Stanley, it just gives us more ballast. It's a capital-light business. It's part of the journey.
We're going to dive into all of those different factors strategically. I want to start on the timing, though, if I may. I asked you specifically about a potential acquisition for E-Trade in December, December 13th. You were kind of sitting on the fence a bit, actually, now I look back at it. David Faber just saying he thought the conversations only started this month. When did they start?
Well, in truth, they started in 2002.
Wow.
Before you were born.
Just about.
Just about. I called them back then when I was at Merrill because I was very intrigued by the fact that there were always going to be segments of clients who only wanted to deal electronically and digitally. And the people who wanted financial advice also wanted digital access. So it was always a buy versus build. Then I called them again, and we had pretty extensive negotiations in 07. And in the end, we couldn't get past their HELOC portfolio, which, you know, proved to be a problem. So these discussions reinitiated in December. Okay. So about the time we were talking, I might have had a little twinkle in my eye.
There we go. Well, that, I think you did. I should have pushed harder back then. But anyway, and in terms of getting it over the line, your stock, it's an all-stock deal. Your stock's up sharply since then. Did that give you the currency, essentially, to get the deal done?
Not really. We, you know, we had the confidence. I mean, our stock was beaten down in the summer, which I thought, and, you know, I get people joke at me for defending our stock, but I kind of think it's my job. And I'm a large individual shareholder. It was ridiculous. We were trading below book value in the summer. I mean, there was that, we'd just produced $8 billion of revenue and a, you know, 11% ROE. So the stock was being beaten down for reasons that were wrong, I felt. No, this was a longer term thing, but certainly gives you more confidence when your currency is strong.
Mm-hmm. In terms of the share price move today, it's down about 4%. Did you? It was very dilutive, the stock issuance. Did you expect it to be down more? Are you pleased with only down 4%?
You know, I totally expect it to be down at the open. I don't know where it'll finish today, a week, a month. You know, it'll bounce back from that. We're still trading above what we were before we started the earnings call in January, and we own E-Trade. So it's kind of like this is not a bad outcome at all. We're up, as you said, 40% from the summer. Listen, it was dilutive on a tangible book. It was accretive on ROTCE. And it will be accretive to earnings within 3 years. So I'm very comfortable with where the numbers are, and I think the stock will trade just fine over the next several weeks.
Was one of the factors about timing also to make sure somebody else didn't buy this asset? Goldman Sachs, in fact, trading down 2% this morning. A win for you? Is it a direct blow for them?
Well, I'm not going to comment on Goldman, but I think, you know, when I think about strategy and big strategic moves, it's all, you've got to have a clear strategic vision. And I never worry about strategy from envy. I'm never trying to copy what somebody else is doing. We've got to do what's right for Morgan Stanley. When you get that done, you've got to be very opportunistic. You've got to move and move quickly. So we put in, obviously, a very full, I think appropriately, bid for a great, great company with an iconic brand. If we'd messed around with that and tried to do this on the cheap, that would have created all sorts of turmoil. So when you make your mind up, you be aggressive to get the job done, and that's what we did.